There's no doubt that the place where someone lives impacts their health and well-being. When I was a practicing nurse in a busy trauma ICU in Philadelphia, it was really hard not to notice the ways in which patients and their families' social and economic resources shaped both their experience in the hospital and the opportunity to recover once they left. When I became a nurse researcher, my NINR-funded dissertation was seeking to explore why there were racial disparities in the outcomes of Black injured patients in the acute healthcare setting. Looking at social and structural environments and investment or disinvestment, green spaces or lack of green spaces, how that changes the way people are able to recover after serious injury. But structural determinants of health are always tricky to study in that it's important to understand the history, like, for example, the history of redlining. Using ethnography, I had the opportunity to spend in-depth time with Black patients and their families to understand how their social, environmental, and economic realities impacted their healthcare experience inside the hospital and what it means to return to places, neighborhoods, and homes that were often very close to the same places that they were hurt. I hope that the work that I have done has started to inspire others to really think about the scope of nursing practice as something that allows you to think about larger social issues, and that the work that we do will impact either clinical practice or policy over time.